learn how to solve questions where reciprocal is involved and we have to find the values related of a series. So sum of a series, basically that is what we are supposed to find. So the first question is, the infinite sum 1 plus 4 by 7 plus 9 by 7 square plus 16 by 7 cube plus so on till infinity, and then we are given 4 options. So I am writing the series. The series is 1 plus 4 by 7, 9 by 7 square, 16 by 7 cube, and so on. Okay. And the options are 27 by 14 is 21 by 13, C is 49 by 27, and D is 256 by 147. So let's look at the series of these. So now you see the substitute terms will become almost negligible. So after this, the value will be 0.001 or something. So if we can almost discard the remaining terms, and we know values of these terms, if we add the values, the answer should be approximately say equal to the actual answer. So we will find the values. So this is 1. Okay, if you see this one, 1 by 7 is 14.28%. So if you multiply with 4, you get around 0.57. 9 by 49. Okay, so it will be around 0.18. This is 16 by 343. So it will divide approximately 0.5 times. If you add everything, we will get 1.8. So our answer should be 1.8 plus something. So 1.8, 1, 2, or 3, or something like that. It won't be a value greater than that. Now let's look at the options. The first option, 27 by 14, which is 1.928, which is quite greater than the number which we have. So almost we can discard it, so this is not possible. 21 by 30, this is equal to 1.61. 30, then we are left with 8. 18 by 30 is 6 and 1. 49 by 27. If you divide this one, we will get 1.81 something, which is quite close to our answer. So this is the probable answer we have. And then something will happen. So 85 or something. Okay. 256 by 147, which is equal to 1, then we are left with 109, which will give us approximately around 7, which is lesser than 1 point. So this one is not possible, even this one is not possible, even this one is not possible. The only possible answer is option C, which is 49 by 27. So by knowing the normal calculation, approximately calculation, we can eliminate the option and get the right answer. Now let's look at another question which is similar, which has similar application. Okay. So I'll erase this question. So the question is, find the following sum, 1 by 2 square minus 1 plus 1 by 4 square minus 1 plus 1 by 6 square minus 1 plus plus 1 by 20 square minus 1. So we have now 10 terms. So I can write the series here. Now the values are like the options as well. Options are 9 by 10, then we have 10 by 11, then we have 19 by 21, and then option D is 10 by 20. Now let's look at this particular question. Again we will do the same process. So 1 by 3, 1 by 3 is 0.33. 1 by 4 square minus 1 is 15, so we get 0.066 and so on. So sum of these should be 0.4. 1 by 35. Okay. So it is 1 by 35, which is less than 0.03, but I like 0.3. And then subsequent terms is a lesser value than that. Okay. So approximately this will be the sum and a bit more compared to this. Okay. Now let's look at the values. This one is 0.9. And this value which we see 0.4 and this is 0.43. Okay, so 0.43, so 0.45 or something like that. This one is 0.90. 19 by 21, again 0.9190, and so 0.904. 10 by 21, so this is 0.4, 16 left, 7, again 13 left, so 6, 0.476. These three values are considerably higher than the value which this sum can attain. So obviously, this one is not possible, this one is not possible, this one is not possible. This is the answer. So without even going through the solution, through option, we can definitely find what is the answer. These two questions are CAT questions. So you can see, even the examiner want you to use your brain and you can use the elimination technique using the options. Now, let's solve these two questions by the conventional method. So if you have not understood this elimination method, let's see what is the conventional method. So the first one, s equal to 1 plus 4 by 7, 9 by 7 square, 16 by 7 cube and so on. So whenever we have, this is a series where we have denominator, in denominator we have 1 by 7 geometry, so common ratio is 1 by 7 and numerator we have a square of 1 by 7. So whenever we get such series where we have the common ratio is 1 by 1 is less than 1, then we can always find the sum using by multiplying this with the common ratio. So I'll multiply with common ratio, so I'll get s by 7, which will give us 1 by 7, 2 by 7 square, 9 by 7 cube and so on. Then we have to subtract first series from the second series, we get 6 by 7, s equal to 1 plus 3 by 7, 5 by 7 square, 7 by 7 cube. Still we do not have the geometric progression, so we have to continue with the piece, we have to repeat this step again. So we multiply with 1 by 7 again. This time we get 1 by 7, 3 by 7 square, 5 by 7 cube and so. And if we subtract this, okay, we will get 36 by 49. Okay, 49 is denominator. So 1 plus 2 by 7, 2 by 7 square, 7 by 7 cube and so on. Now you see from here onwards is a G. Is a G. Okay, with common ratio less than 1, so we can definitely find the sum. So I write it as 1 plus 2 by 7. The formula is A by 1 minus R. So 1 minus 1 by 7 is 6 by 7. Okay. So 1 plus 1 by 3. So this is 4 by 3. So s is equal to 4 by 3 into 49 by 36. Which will give us 49 by 27. Which was the correct answer we guessed earlier. So this is the method. So whenever we are given a common ratio series, this is the conventional method through which we can solve such questions. Now let's look at the second question we have solved earlier. How to solve that, those kind of questions. It is this. So the series which we have done was 1 by 2 square minus 1, 1 by 4 square minus 1, 1 by 6 square minus 1, 1 by 20 square minus 1. So in denominator we have 2 square minus 1, 4 square minus 1, 6 square minus 1, 8 square minus 1. So this is 2 square minus 1 square. So what we can see is a square minus b square, this is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So this can be written as a square minus b square, so a minus b into a plus b. So 2 minus 1, 1 and 2 plus b. Similarly, this can be written as 4 minus 1 and 4 plus 1. So I'll get 3 into 5. Next one, 5 into 7. And in the end, we'll get 19 into 21. 20 minus 1 into 20 plus 1. Now, to solve such series, what we are supposed to do is we have to split this term in a manner that we get a part, two parts of this particular fraction. So I can write this as, I'll take 1 by 2 common, because difference of these two is 2. If difference would have been 3, let's say 1 and 4, 4 and 7, then I would have taken 1 by 3 common, because in numerator we want the difference, 3 minus 1. So I write 3 minus 1 here. So if 1 by 4 would have, then it would have written as 4 into 4 minus 1. If 1 by 5, 1 into 5, in that case we would have written 5 minus 1. So requirement would have been of 4. Anyways, we'll continue. Okay, so that's all for it. 5 minus 3 into 3 by 5. 7 minus 5 into 5 into 7. And then 21 minus 19 divided by 19 into 21. Now, this term is 1 and this is minus 1 by 3. So I'll write it as 1 by 2 into. So we have 1 minus 1 by 3. This is, if you see first part, S is it is 1 by 3, and second part is 1 minus 1 by 5. Then we have 1 plus 1 minus 7, and so on. In the last class, minus 1 plus 1 by 19 minus 1 by 21. All the parts which are in middle, these will cancel out. So what we are left with, 1 by 2, 1 minus 1 by 21, 1 by 2 into 10 by 20 by 21. So the answer is 10 by 20. So whenever you get such question where we have, in numerator you have 1 and in denominator is multiplication of two numbers, and throughout the series the difference is constant, so you have to take 1 by that difference as common, and in numerator we'll write 1 as, let's say in this case 3 minus 1, in case of difference 4, we could have written as 4 minus 1 and so. So this is the way to solve such questions, if you are to follow the conventional method. So that is all in this video. Thank you very much.